opinion, he wasn't a man that was ever random in what he did. You know, even in this later period, this music, which sounds so completely, you know, unbound by the common sort of musical structure. But for me, it's some of his most thought out and organized music. You know?
The latter part of John Coltrane's career, of course, is a very challenging one, even to this day. It's controversial. And when you really take a moment to listen to what he's doing here, this is one of the most revelatory pieces of music. It's called Offering. It was performed at Temple University. So it almost begs to be taken on a spiritual level, too. He had amassed and recruited some fellow travelers who were also cut from the same experimental cloth, so to speak. You've got Pharoah Sanders, who's on saxophones, Alice Coltrane on piano, Rashid Ali on drums, Sonny Johnson on bass, who's sitting in for Jimmy Garrison, the regular bassist, a whole coterie of Philadelphia-based percussion players. He's with the band that he wants to be performing with at the time. And he's elevating. He's elevating the music, elevating himself, and elevating the audience. So, you know, it was more than just a jazz concert. It was a very special event that had life-changing effect on a lot of people who were in that moment, who witnessed that concert, either on stage or in front of the stage.
So when I had a chance to get up and solo, I really already felt the uplifting, transcendental, spiritual power of what was going on. You really had a sense of a unique moment. And when the drummer started, you know, going behind me, I didn't remember this until when the other players mentioned it to Ashley, that I was actually jumping up and down as I was soloing. So I just felt uplifted. I've never done that before since. It was just the nature of the day.
I had a conversation with Michael Brecker sometime in the early 2000s, and he mentioned the only time that he had seen John Coltrane perform live was in 1966, Temple University. I said to Michael, I think I have a copy of that tape, you know, the next time I saw him. I gave him the disc, and he called me the next day, and it sounded like he was so overcome with joy. It almost sounded like there were tears in his eyes when he was just speaking of the experience of rehearing that concert again.
There's a legend about this concert, and the legend all revolves around Coltrane chanting, taking the horn out of his mouth and starting to sing, wordless syllables, even banging on his chest a little bit to get a certain effect out.
He begins to vocalize, I say sing, and he's changing the vocalization by beating his chest. Originally hearing that, it was this incredible affirmation that yes, nothing he did was by chance. It was really a part of a fuller and more broader functional kind of concept.
Resonance Records is extremely proud and honored to be a partner with Universal Music Enterprises and the John Coltrane Estate to present this historical, important document. At Resonance, we are committed to preserving jazz legacies and bringing important recordings to light. John Coltrane's Offering is a project we're extremely proud to be a part of.
When you listen to this, you hear a master in total control, and that's one of the other great discoveries on Offering, is that we really hear the master at work. So bits and pieces of Offering have been available in the past, but nowhere near the fidelity that we now have it in. And this complete concert really needs to be heard from beginning to end. It's one of the best examples of what it must have been like to suddenly be assaulted with this new way of performing jazz and realizing, oh my God, something really new is happening here.
Thanks to Mr. Yasuhiro Fujioka at the John Coltrane House of Osaka, Japan, he was able to lead us to the tape reels, which were tracked down to WRTI-FM in Philadelphia. As a result, We've gone back to the original tape reels and done a direct transfer at 96 kilohertz, 24 bits, enabling the best mastering sound possible.
It's nice to be able to put this music out. You know, it's like a buried treasure in lots of ways. You know, something that's existed for decades, but it's been recently unearthed. You know.
Resonance Records will donate a portion of every sale of Offering to the John Coltrane Home, a 501c3 foundation devoted to the preservation of John Coltrane's home in Dix Hills, New York. For more information, go to www.thejohncoltranehome.org. Thanks so much for your support. ¶¶